वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल कदम एकेडमी। आई प्रकाश कदम इज हियर टुडे टू शेयर विथ यू द फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। द प्राइमरी फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट इज प्लानिंग। प्लानिंग दिस प्लानिंग इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन टू पार्ट, पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू, एंड विद द नंबर ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स। सी हियर द वेरियस पिक्चर्स यू कैन सी in part 1 and part 2. Please be with me. This is the example of this Chak De movie. See, this is the, in Chak De movie, Shah Rukh Khan becomes the coach of the girls hockey team. He knows what he has to prepare the girls for international hockey matches and win the cup. For this, he prepares a long-term plan and thinks of ways of how to beat the opponent team. उसे पता था कि long-term plan he has prepared, उसने बनाया उन्होंने, and this opponent team has to beat it. So he coaches the girls to play in different ways like defensive, offensive, etc. At the outset of this match, he explained who will open the match and how the ball will be passed by one player to another step by step. So dosto, isme aapko identify karna hai, you have to identify all the types of plan mentioned above, and you will study in part 1 and part 2 of this planning. Okay, so friends, here learning outcome of this planning. After going through this concept, the student and learner would be able to understand the concept of planning, describe the importance of planning. Students will be able to describe the importance of planning, and students will understand the limitation of planning. Learner will describe the steps in process of planning, and the last, learner must able to develop objectives, policies, strategy, procedure, method, rule, budget, program as types of plan. Also, you can able to differentiate between these objectives and policies. So be with us. Planning concept. Of planning definition. According to Lourdes and O'Daniel, planning is a deciding in advance what to do, how to do it, when to do it, and who is to do it. Planning involves tasks that must be performed to attain organizational goals, outlining how the task must be performed and indicating when they should be performed. So what is the planning then? The planning is the bridge between this gap between what, the present status where we are, and future status where we want to go. In between these two, this bridge is nothing but the planning. So importance of planning. First importance is the planning provides direction to the where to go, and planning reduces the risk of uncertainty. Whatever be uncertainty will be there, and that can be reduced. Someone has said risk is measurable uncertainty, but uncertainty is unmeasurable risk. Third one is the planning reduces wasteful activities. Whatever the wasteful activities during this achieving the goal, that may be time, money, energy, that we can reduce. The planning promotes innovative ideas. Whatever the ideas, the planning can be promote. planning facilitates decision making. Planning establishes standards for controlling. So this controlling part, that standards we can establish for the achieving the objects or goal. So planning provides direction. See here, the target we have to achieve. So we have to do the planning by stating in advance how the work is to be done. Planning provides direction for action. If there was no planning, employees would be working in different directions and organization would not be able to achieve its goal efficiently. So friends, planning contributes objectives. How? See here, planning always states start with the determination of objectives. We cannot think of planning in absence of objectives. After setting up an objective, planning decides the methods, procedure, and steps to achieve those objectives. We'll describe one example. For an example, for an organization has objective of manufacturing 1500 washing machine or fridge in a month, then organization need to plan their activities according to the objective to achieve their target in desired month. So what they have to plan, dosto, yahan pe kya karna hai company ko? This organization has to plan to manufacture this washing machine or fridge within 1 month. So according to this objective, they have to plan. So planning involves decision making process. When there is a two alternatives are there, various alternatives are there, then we have to choose the suitable alternative. We cannot imagine planning in absence of choice, because if there is no alternative available, then there is no requirement of planning. So time taken by the planning can be top to down or bottom to top. See here in the diagram, this is topmost management, middle and lower management. Here the top to bottom or bottom to top, or it involves communicate with all concerned. Plans must be flexible and dynamic. Evaluate and revise. So before going to study more planning, first we see the what are the limitations of planning. Limitations of planning are internal limitations and external limitations. In internal limitations, the planning leads to rigidity. The rules, regulations, or the old thinking that will be disturb the planning. The planning may not work in dynamic environment. The planning involves huge cost. There will be limitation. Planning is time consuming. So planning does not guarantee of success. Success will be achieved. Aapko success milega ya nahi milega, that will not guarantee. The planning reduces creativity. Creativity also reduces here. The external limitations, they are those limitations of planning which arise due to external factors over which an organization has no control. See, corona is there. That is the external limitation. How? The changes in the government policies. The policies are changed. The BS4 vehicles are nowadays, they are going to close down. These norms are changed. BS6 norms are coming. This will be failure of planning. After that, the natural calamities such as flood, earthquake, COVID-19, etc. also adversely affect the success of planning. After that, these changes in the strategies of competitors, the opposite competitors, those are competitor companies, are they will change their strategies, also affect the failure of the planning many times. And regular technological changes may affect the planning. Changes in the economic or social condition also reduces the effectiveness of planning, like in COVID-19. Friends, the features, we'll study the features of the planning. The planning focuses on the achieving objectives. Planning is a primary function of management. Planning is pervasive. That means a group of people, those are working. Planning is futuristic. Planning involves decision making. Already we have studied. Planning is a mental exercise. Planning is continuous. We'll see one by one these 2-3 points. The planning is mental exercise. How? Planning is known as mental exercise as it is related to higher thinking process. Before doing something, a planner has to mainly think about the questions. He has to think very much like 4 questions: what to do, how to do it, when to do it, who is to do it. Think, that will be mental exercise. Planning is the continuous process. Planning is never ending, because the beginning of the business, that will planning will start with the ending of the business, planning will stop. It means as long as business exists, the planning process is continuous. So for this, these PDCA, PDCA, PDCR, that plan, do, check and review. The review is the evaluate the review plan and management decision, and C for the check, implement, monitor program. First we have to plan, after do it, implement the action plan, after that check is and review it. These are the PDCR. Okay, so dosto, you have to watch it part 2 for more example and remaining part of this planning. So subscribe my channel Kadam Academy. Thank you very much.